In this video, I'm going to teach you about partial edge control, so how to insert your last pair differently to influence the OLL case that you'll get. So firstly, I'm going to explain why it can be a good idea to use partial edge control. So the main reason is that the OLL algorithms for the dot cases, so where you have zero of your last layer edges oriented, are on average longer and more difficult to execute than the other OLL cases. So therefore, it makes sense to, when it's easily possible to orient some edges during your F2L, to do so. Also, if you're still learning OLL and haven't learnt the dot cases yet, partial edge control is a useful way to avoid running into OLL cases that you don't know. So we can do this by comparing two ways to insert F2L pairs. So when you have a pair that you need to insert into your F2L, the regular way to insert it is by doing U, R, U prime, R prime, like that. However, notice that when we do those moves, that doesn't affect the orientation of any edges on our cube. However, another way we can insert this F2L pair is by doing R prime, F, R, F prime, like that. And that actually changes the orientation of two edges. So reversing that, we can see that doing R prime, F, R, F prime inserts this F2L pair into the front right slot and orients this edge and this edge, like so. So then, if we get to the final pair and we're about to insert it, but we notice there are zero last layer edges oriented, we can use R prime, F, R, F prime to orient two of them to give ourselves an OLL with two edges oriented. So we do want to be careful about how frequently we use the sledgehammer versus the normal insert, because it is slightly slower, and most of the time doing a sledgehammer won't actually give you an advantage. So it's only when this edge and this edge are both misoriented that it actually makes a difference. So for example here, if we have this edge misoriented but this edge is oriented, if we just do a U, R, U prime, R prime, they stay the same, so that one remains misoriented and that one remains oriented. However, if we do an R prime F, R F prime, that'll just change this one from being misoriented to oriented, and this one from oriented to misoriented. So there'll be barely any difference, and you'll still have an OLL with only two edges oriented. So apart from the dot case, the other place where you might want to use this is where you have these two edges in the back are both oriented, and these two misoriented. So it's the same thing. We're just orienting these two, but this time we have these two oriented so that when we do our sledgehammer, R prime, F, R, F prime, we'll get an OLL case with all of the edges oriented.